With me is...
Hi, I'm Bill Leipold from the University at Stony Brook.
And I'm Craig Elliott from St. Mary's College, California.
Craig, is this your first time here in Washington to see the quilt?
Yes, it is. I've seen the quilt in its regional section, but not all together. This is my first time.
Okay, and how about you, Bill?
No, I was down here in 1992. I've worked in several quilt displays in the Northeast region, and so I'm down here again.
Tell me what this impact has meant to you, the seeing the quilt, the amount of people, the enormous size of the quilt from one end to the other.
I think the first thing that strikes me is I know now that it's grown a great deal since 1992. We're on the other side of Washington Monument, where you looked at it was kind of vast, but to look an entire mile from the Capitol down to the Washington Monument and see it packed with people and nothing but fabric is a really major impact. And to know that this quilt may even grow by 5,000 or 7,000 more panels this weekend is kind of mind-boggling and overwhelming in terms of how this whole entire disease has affected us all.
Have you lost anybody that you've known to AIDS?
Yes, at this point I've lost almost 5 people that I know personally, and I also worked at an AIDS service organization in Pennsylvania. I've lost a great deal of people that were my clients. So,
Craig, how about yourself? I mean, seeing, again, the size of this and the amount of people, people coming from different states, you're from California, what does this have, what kind of an impact on you?
Well, I have to say honestly that I'm overwhelmed. I mean, it kind of makes me numb to realize that there's 40,000 some odd people here represented here, which is only what, 10% of the population who've died of AIDS. So it's just kind of, I think numb is the word for it.
Gentlemen, what brought you here to Washington? First of all, do you live in Washington?
No, we're from Seattle.
From Seattle, okay. So what brought you here today?
Well, we have a number of friends that are involved in the AIDS project, and they invited us to attend today.
And is this your first time ever seeing the quilt displayed in Washington, D.C.?
Yeah.
What is your...
Ever seeing it displayed.
Ever seeing it displayed. What is, being a first time to seeing the quilt in its entirety, what is the impact it has on you today?
It's...
sobering to me.
Yeah. It's very impacting. I don't know. I think it brings forth quite a number of emotions. It's... at the same time that I'm glad to see it here, I'm also very sad to see it, and in such great numbers. I think it's exciting to see the number of people here looking at it.
The supportive people.
Exactly.
Feeling the impact of AIDS. But emotionally, what is it, you know, how does it make you feel about what's the impact it has on today's world?
Well, it makes me hopeful that, you know, as sad as it may be that AIDS has touched enough people, that perhaps finally, you know, people may have enough personal interest in it that, you know, there may be a little bit more sense of urgency to finding a cure or, you know, anything to help research and that type of thing.
How about yourself? How about, how does this, seeing this here today, how does that make you feel?
Well, it makes me feel that, you know, we've come a long way in getting people to deal with, you know, who they really are and being able to acknowledge that. And although, you know, it's very tragic, I think there's a lot of symbolism here, and it is very encouraging to see all the people that have turned out for this.
Hi, my name's Craig. I'm here from Miami. And actually a year ago, pretty much to this day, I found out about my own diagnosis as being HIV positive. So to me, this is kind of a time for me to recognize where I've come and what I've done in the last year with my own self and my health. And I'm just excited to see the quilt, knowing that so many changes have happened with the HIV community, and there's so much hope now. And being newly diagnosed, that I will have this hope in this future that a lot of our brothers and sisters didn't have.
I'm Steve, and I'm from Ohio, and I've known Craig, who just talked, since I was born, basically. And he told me he was going to be out here, and he told me that he was HIV positive a month or so ago. So I came out to be with him, and I did see the quilt yesterday. And I saw it in 1993 also, and it's always sort of a, I don't even really know how to describe it. It's sort of, you run the gamut of emotions from being really, you know, terribly sad to angry. And it's a very powerful experience. I don't even really know how to describe it. So we're on our way back there right now, I guess.
I'm Brian, I'm from Honolulu, Hawaii, and I'm here with my lover who had to attend a conference, but also to see the quilt, and probably just use it to memorialize some friends that we've lost, and that's about it.
I'm Tim, I'm from Honolulu. I'm here for the conference, but also want to see the quilt because my best friend died last June.
Hi, I'm Robert. I'm from Boston, and I'm here for two reasons, to see the quilt for very personal reasons, and also to be with my friends who you've mostly met, all of them. So it's a happy and a sad occasion for me.
So you're going to be planning on going down to the AIDS quilt?
Oh, I'll definitely go to see the AIDS quilt.
Okay. Yeah. Do you have any, does it affect you in any way, or the impact of the quilt being displayed at the mall?
I saw it the last time it was displayed.
Yeah,
it's really overwhelming when you see it visually.
Yeah.
And, you know, all those lives and people. Yeah, it's incredible.
Well, it makes you think a lot to see it. Yeah.
Have you seen it before?
Yeah. It must have been 3 or 4 years ago I saw it down on the Ellipse.
Who's the quilt for?
For our son, her brother.
And how old is he?
He was 27.
Okay. From where are you from?
Potomac, Maryland.
Maryland? Okay. Is this the first time you're here in Washington for the quilt?
Yes.
Okay. And who made the quilt?
We all did.
Okay. And you're presenting it today or tomorrow?
Today.
Okay. You with family?
Yes.
In loving memory of Michael Carter Rusk, April 26, 1967, your family and friends. It's a beautiful, beautiful quilt.
Well, we all work in different capacities in the Human Rights Campaign. We work in the Development Department. Jonathan works in the Administrative Department. And we're out here today to help sell T-shirts and help be visible and help remember people who died of AIDS and to be part of this weekend. So.
And have you been to the quilt yet?
Not yet. We've been working today, so hopefully tomorrow morning.
Have you seen the quilt before at all? Or?
Yeah, I saw it. I've seen it twice before, but nothing like this. You know, it's three times the size the last time I saw it, so... You know, it's going to be something.
How about, have you seen the quilt before?
I saw the quilt also yesterday and the last time it was out, but it is like twice the size at least of the last time it was here.
Have you been personally affected at all by the impact of AIDS, or have you known anybody with AIDS?
Yeah, actually, this is my partner, and the man who introduced us passed away about a year and a half ago, and we just finished his panel about 10 minutes ago. So it's going to be part of the quilt as of about a half hour.
You'll be going down to turn the panel in as a new panel dedication?
It's on its way right now.
Great. And have you seen the quilt at all?
No, I haven't. This will be my first time.
Very first time. How about yourself?
Yeah, I've seen it before when it was here 3 years ago. It's pretty moving.
And emotionally, what has it done for you by seeing something of this, you know, enormous quilt display, the magnitude? Thank you.
The magnitude. It's a great catharsis, I think, for the community to sort of focus on the grieving process. And it's a tremendously beneficial thing for us to really move ahead with. So from that point of view, it's just a great effort.
Okay. All right, guys. Thank you very much.